Our next speaker, in my personal opinion, is the smartest mind in digital marketing in the automotive business. That's saying a lot. There are a lot of good people in this business. He co-founded PureCars in 2007 at the age of 24. They now serve over 2,000 dealers nationally with their PureCars suite of technology. I met Jeremy through a mutual dealer friend in 2009. I was immediately struck by his extraordinary ability to understand how the car business relates to the digital world, and more importantly, how critical it is that the customer get the right message with the right content as early as possible in the process. Critical stuff. As we've grown to know each other, I've also been amazed at his ability not only to see where the market is, but where the market is going. We need leaders who are looking out ahead of us and seeing what's taking place. And Jeremy has a mind that looks out not just at what's happening now, but what happens next, and then next, and then next. He's been consistently ahead of the curve, not only in technology, but more importantly, in thought process. I'm confident that once you see what Jeremy has in store for you today, you'll agree with me. He's one of the brightest minds in the car business. Please welcome Jeremy Anspach.
I grew up in Detroit, so cars have been in my blood since I've probably been 2 years old. Detroit's built around the auto industry, so it's always been something I've had an interest in. My grandmother, as an immigrant, came here, barely spoke English, and got a job at Ford, and she worked there her whole career, and it was always something that she spoke so proudly of. I think cars are a part of my blood. It's something that, it's around Motor City, it's what it's all about. I mean, I think growing up, just seeing my dad pull out this 1967 Corvette from the garage, and it reminds me today of my childhood because I interacted with him in this beautiful vehicle that we still have in the family today. A car like that just had, you have so many memories around it. It really is a lot more than just a piece of metal. For most Americans, they're lucky enough to make a vehicle almost a fashion statement. It's part of their identity. It's what they want. It's in the US, for most of us, you need a vehicle for transportation. That's how you get to work. That's how you can take care of your family. And the fact that we've been able to create more relevant information to improve the car buying experience is huge. And to see that this year alone, we've impacted over 20 million consumers and showed them valuable information to help them make a more informed decision when they're purchasing a pre-owned vehicle is something we're really proud of. The most progressive dealers in the country are embracing technology and using it to showcase everything they know about that vehicle digitally, and as a result, showing true transparency and winning these customers. To me, the auto industry defines America. It's job creation, it's innovation, it's far more than just an industry. I think a car is, to some people, a lot more than transportation. It's something that you enjoy driving, it's something that you're proud of, it's something that your family can enjoy with you. A car is almost part of your soul. I'm Jeremy Anspach, and I love the car business.
Hello, everyone. I'm proud to be here today. I was here in the audience last year and thought this was one of the best events I've ever attended, and it's incredible to be on stage today. You know, I think the introduction Larry gave said a lot. I'll say that I've loved this car business since I was about this high. It's something I've always wanted to be in, and I'm proud to be in it. You know, at PureCars, our mission is to provide more relevant information to improve the car buying experience. And what I'm here to present today is what we've learned through billions of data points. Some of the best people in the industry who work for us today, we have about 100 employees, have really helped us look at what is relevant and how do you use that to win the click. The presentation today is focused on how to win the click on your website, Google search and retargeting, and how you turn these clicks into showroom opportunities, since that's what matters most. You know, at the end of the day, it's hilarious. Every time I talk about winning the click, people will always say to me before I come up on stage, so how do I win the click? And I always like to say it's real simple, just keep it simple. And sometimes they look at me like, what are you talking about? If it's so simple, you got 45 minutes here. What are we gonna talk about? And I always like to say, well, I didn't say it was easy. So I want to start off with the big picture. I think this will really make a lot of sense for everyone here, and it will allow us to set a really good foundation. When you think about a strategy, and for my presentation, a digital strategy. Every good strategy absolutely starts with a goal in mind. And the question is, we're in January of 2014, we're here for NADA, or some of us are starting tomorrow. What should our goal be? You know, it's amazing. You're gonna see there's so many things to consider. It's endless. Is it more Facebook likes? There's gonna be vendors telling you it's all about Facebook likes. Is it more Twitter followers? It's gonna be about tweeting more and all the other terminology around Twitter. Some vendors are gonna say it's all about driving more traffic to your website, and others are gonna say it's about keeping them there longer. And it goes on and on and on. Some vendors are gonna talk about how it's all about the vehicle details page, it's all about the VDP, get them there, and there's all these fancy statistics to say you'll sell more cars. And then there's the more old school approach that says, all that doesn't really matter, I just want more phone calls. So what do I need to do? Put my phone number higher on the page? What do I need to do to generate more calls? And then there's a train of thought saying, all that's kind of relevant, but at the end of the day, I just want more appointments, because if I can get an appointment, we know what to do from there. And then lastly, there's guys that say, just get me more leads. It's all about leads. You know, in my opinion, everything I just mentioned does matter. But what matters most to everyone in this dealership, in a dealership, is more showroom opportunities. And that is absolutely what the focus should be in 2014. With that said, when you think about how do you achieve this, you know, it's amazing how many vendors will always talk about, we'll sell you more cars. How many dealers will have sales meetings at the beginning of the year saying, yes, it's a new year. It's all about selling more cars. But the question is, what strategy do they have in place to actually achieve what they're saying? And I'm hoping today that this presentation is going to give you some good insight on how to do that. And I want to start off by talking about the foundation. At the end of the day, when you think about the foundation, how many of you have focused on leads? Just say over the last 5 to 10 years, have leads been a focus in your internet departments? Raise your hand. All right, so most of you. There's been a significant shift in the industry. I call it going from the lead to showroom shift. Think about industries that generate leads today. Real estate? Absolutely. But there's a lot of unique attributes of real estate. First of all, there's not 9 to 5 hours. What I mean by that is you can't just tour any home that's on the market from 9 to 5. People live in it. They're living in their homes. They're not all sitting on a lot. There's a lot of complicated questions. So it's somewhat online is about showing relevant information and it turns into a lead. People don't just knock on a door that's for sale and say, hey, show it to me. Another industry that comes to mind is the insurance business. I mean, when you think about the insurance business, there's extremely complicated quotes. It's not product-based. But when you think about the car business and you think about dealerships, we're very similar to normal retailers. We have normal business hours. We have inventory on the lot. We have great websites with the intent to show consumers relevant information. So the question is, why are leads in our DNA? And since I've been a young kid, as I mentioned, I've loved the car business, and I remember going to websites when it was just a homepage, and maybe the Porsche dealer had the new Porsche on there and it rotated across the few, but they didn't even have inventory. So when you think about the digital strategy many years ago, you can summarize it by saying that consumers didn't have relevant content. For example, cars didn't have photographs. As the shift progressed, you started taking photos of your used cars. It went from one photo, and the most progressive guys out there maybe took 3. And then there was this thing about pricing, and who would want to price their car online? So there was no pricing. I would bet almost everyone in this room who's been in the car business more than 6 or 7 years has been and knows exactly what I've talked about so far. So what did this all mean? It meant that consumers had to submit leads, or they needed to go what I call old school. And what old school is they went to multiple dealerships. And when you look at statistics, less than 6 years ago, the average consumer visited 4.5 dealers before making a purchase. As of last year, it's 1.4. Why? Today, and in recent years, the digital information age has made us all change. And when you think about how consumers behave today, I wanted to start with some really good stats to kind of prove this out so we're all on the same page, as this is critical from a foundation standpoint. When you think about the marketing model, it's three steps. I think Procter & Gamble summarizes this quite well. You have your stimulus, and your stimulus results in your TV, radio, billboard, which drives people to the shelf. And then from there, it leads them to the experience, the meet and greet, the test drive, what they thought of the automobile, the experience after the test drive, and all of that turns into a sale. But that's changed. One of the most powerful books I've ever read is Zero Moment of Truth. This is a book that Google published approximately 2 years ago. And what they proved in this book, and obviously I'm not going to recite the book to you, but I'm going to hit some of the highlights, is that the marketing model has changed. The stimulus, the TV, radio, billboard, etc., does not drive people to your shelf, being your dealership. It drives people to do online learning. And Google calls that ZMONT, Zero Moment of Truth. And every time I talk about Zero Moment of Truth, there's always a few dealers who say, well, does that really apply to me? I mean, I've been doing traditional advertising for decades and it works. I sell 300 cars a month. So luckily for me, Google, in their Zero Moment of Truth book, actually created a cross-category chart that lists out all of the key industries that spend money in advertising, and that included automotive. And what you'll see on the screens right here is that the automotive industry is really impactful for how consumers behave and what they learn. The average consumer looks at 18.2 sources before purchasing. We've had the privilege of having a very close relationship with Google, and actually before I got up here today, I was talking to the guest speaker that you guys will see at lunch, and we were briefly talking about Zero Moment of Truth, and there's some new stats that's showing it's not 18.2, it's approximately 24. So it's going up. It's going up because consumers want to do online learning and they want relevant information and they want to find it themselves. You'll also notice on this statistic is, so what? They're looking at these stats, they're looking at all these different sites and information, but does it mean anything? 97% of people were impacted by what they learned. The only industry higher than that was travel. It makes perfect sense. If my wife calls me and said, hey, let's go on a vacation, I haven't seen you in months, it seems like. Let's go to Barcelona. Here's a hotel, and I look at it and I go, wait a minute, this is one-star reviews. I wouldn't go any further, why would I? I'd be done. Underneath travel is auto. When you think about 18.2 sources, it's a lot. But look, it goes by quick. Carfax, PureCars report, Better Business Bureau, Google reviews that they find, maybe a community activism blog on a dealership's website. You see, all this is impactful and all this would count towards the sources. And what's amazing to me is when you look at all the industries combined, the stimulus influences the consumer. This is our ad budget, 76% of the time. Zero Moment of Truth is more impactful than your beautiful showroom, which influences consumers 77% of the time. Zero Moment of Truth, as you can see, influences them 84%. It's higher than anything else. How many of you have not read Zero Moment of Truth? Could you raise your hands? Okay, awesome. For those of you who have iPads or Kindles or iPhones or just want to PDF it and then print it, this is an ebook that you can just Google Zero Moment of Truth and you can download it. Anyone in the dealership world, from fixed ops to variable, I would have them read it. It's phenomenal. It's not a big read, don't worry, you can read it on the flight home. You know, why am I showing this to you? The bottom line is consumers are learning, And as a result, dealers have reacted. Now, whether it was proactive or reactive is a different story, but they did react. All of you today understand that listing your inventory quickly online decreases turn, or increases turn, allows you to sell your car quicker. And the result is more opportunities, of course. You now take a lot of photos of your vehicles. You all know the result of a lot of photos that are quality is absolutely more opportunities. You write good comments. You try to write really good comments that can win the customer over by making them understand the value in the vehicle. And as a result, you generated more opportunities. This is the progression of the digital shift. And then there's this big thing called price. How many of you do not price your cars online? There's not one hand up. So everyone in this room prices their cars. And what did we learn from it? Most of us most likely have pricing tools and other technologies to make sure that we're priced right. And as a result, we've created more demand. But there's been one big problem. We have suffered major margin erosion as a result. So the million-dollar question, or actually multi-billion-dollar question as an industry is, should price be the main comparison point from a consumer standpoint when they're online? And you know, I may not be the smartest guy in the world, but I look at the best out there in other industries and say, what are they doing that works? And when you look at the biggest retailers like Amazon, which I'm sure almost everyone in this room has either bought from or uses on a regular basis, there's a lot of key things that they do that should be in our DNA in 2014 and beyond. First, fast and easy searching. I have never gone to Amazon and typed something that I didn't see relevant search results. And what they're showing me is in demand. And if clearly it is competitively priced. If I'm at Lowe's and I see something and I go to Amazon to see if there's something similar or better, Lowe's doesn't have it for $19 and Amazon has it for $99. Clearly it's competitively priced and they have a huge selection. And then when you click on that product from their search results page to what would be a product display page, what do we see? Well, first of all, we see very highly relevant content. What do I mean by this? Just look at their photos. Most products, these photos aren't in some random order. They're in the order that impacts the consumers with the highest relevancy. They show reviews. They don't hide the bad reviews. You see, if you read Zero Moment of Truth, you'll see that there's actually a lot of proof that proves that if you have a few negative reviews amongst a lot of good reviews, it actually is more impactful and will help you sell more product. Why? Because consumers want real information. So you look at what Amazon is doing, and this is very interesting. They don't filter anything. You then see questions and answers. They don't just show the newest, they show the most impactful, or better yet, the most relevant. And then you look back at this product display page, which in our world would be a vehicle displays page, and everything they're showing is focused on relevancy. They're showing the most relevant information first, and then everything after below the fold. And yes, price does matter, and they are always competitively priced, in my opinion. But they also focus on other unique value attributes to give them a competitive advantage. A lot of speakers have talked about over the years how price is just one thing. They're right. The question is how do you actually go home with an action plan to say, how do you build more value? Well, with Amazon, they created Prime. Prime wasn't guesswork from a marketing department. Prime is focused on providing the most relevant value attributes that mean the most to an online shopper. Fast and free shipping, and then all their other things they offer like TV streaming and access to Kindle and programs and things of that nature. Because Amazon realizes that value is far more than just price. And as a result, they're one of the biggest online retailers in the world. They know that if they can show you the right product and educate you on all the relevant information, they'll sell a ton of it. And we all know the success of them. So look, at the bottom line is getting a good deal matters. Amazon proves it. And the question is, how does this apply to you? You know, consumer behavior does not change for the car business. In fact, it's amplified. When you think about it, buying a vehicle is the second largest purchase consumers make. Of course it's amplified. It means more than a $39 accessory for their iPhone. So as a result, as you could see from Zero Moment of Truth, there's more online learning that's happening. And consumers want more than just price. They want relevant content. They want it exactly how it is when they buy any other product. So to master the digital foundation and to improve margin, we need to focus on relevancy. And by focusing on relevancy and answering the top concerns of a shopper, we can put ourselves in a position and realize that price is just one factor, but there's a lot more. We did a focus group when we started PureCars, and this was when it was me and my partner without any employees. And we had this premise that value was more than just price. And we researched websites like Amazon and saw how the engagement was. So we showed 50 people 2 3x5 cards. And on one of them, we wrote $16,000 for a 2007 Honda Accord. And on the other 3x5 card, the same year, make and model, with the price being $17,000, just like you see on the screen. And we asked one question individually to 50 people, which was, which is a better deal? As a dealer, being such a big group, I'm not going to go around and ask the question, but I'm very confident if I said, so which is a better dealer, you would absolutely say you have no idea. Why? Why don't you have an idea? It's because you need more relevant information. You didn't know the trim, the color, the condition, has it been dropped off of a bridge twice? You didn't know any of this stuff. You didn't even know mileage. But what do you think 49 out of the 50 people said when we asked them? The lower priced car. So should you guys leave today with your heads down going, oh, the game's over? Absolutely not. The reason they said that is because they didn't see any more relevant information other than price. So during this focus group, we went back and asked one more question. That question was, what if that higher priced car had all the things you see on the right? It had new tires, it had new brakes, it was a popular color, it was a one owner, it had great equipment like leather, etc. And that lower priced vehicle just had ABS brakes and body color side molding and all the things that most of our vehicle details page shows today. Would you still have picked the lower priced car when I asked the question, which is a better deal? And what do you think they said? How many of you think the lower? Absolutely. Over 80% said no. They would have picked the higher priced car. So it is absolutely critical to show the value in a pre-owned vehicle, in any vehicle for that matter. So with that said, let's dive deeper. You know, I've spoken at 20 groups and a lot of in other settings where it's smaller. And I always like to say, so with all this said, do you focus on price or value? And what's amazing is how many dealerships will say value, and then I'll look at their print advertising and it looks like what you see on the screen. I'm in the car business, I don't know anything going on other than price and a photo I can barely see. Well, I'm not here to talk about traditional, I'm here to talk about how to win the click. So I want to dive a lot deeper on a dealer's website. And I want us to think about, how do consumers shop online? In fact, I just want you to think about, how do you shop online? And let's determine if it's focused on price or value. Now for this presentation, I want to focus on used. You know, a typical homepage, it focuses on price. I look at the search results page, I have no idea what the difference is between these vehicles, do you? I see two black Tahoes, same year, the only difference is about $3,000 in price. So I decided to click. I look at the vehicle details page. My brain, as every other consumer's is to gravitate towards relevant content. I look at the equipment listed on this vehicle and it starts off with one touchdown and a tilt steering wheel. Wow, I'm impressed. This is the first thing shown under convenience features. I then click on the options tab. From here I see four-wheel disc brakes and I'm really impressed. I then say, okay, maybe I'm getting too detailed. Let me just go to the overview section, and basically all I saw was a VIN number, a color, and a stock number. So I turn to the comments. 4D Sport Utility Vortec 5.3L V8 SPI. Call for more details. Are we going to change the way consumers behave when they come to our website? Absolutely not. So to go back to my question, which is the difference between these two Tahoes? The only thing I could see, and I'm in this business and I love the car business, and I've been to thousands of dealer websites and thousands of lots, is price. So what does our consumers see? Nothing more than just price. So the question is, how do you promote value? How many of you recondition your vehicles? Raise your hand. Okay, it's everybody. Well, a lot of statistics show that the average dealer spends over $700 in recon. And some of you are progressive and actually show a used car folder to those on your lot. After a test drive, maybe before a test drive, you're showing them this information, and in it, you'll put in repair orders. And I always have this question of, are these repair orders easy to understand? Because when I take my car in for service, it's in all caps, it's all abbreviated. I know Jeff was saying, don't say RO. Well, hell, don't show them an RO, because what's on the page doesn't make sense most of the time. So it's critical to say, if you have this in the showroom, it needs to be relevant and understandable, and you most importantly need to show this online, and you need to show it graphically, and you need to focus on what's relevant that you did during recon, like new tires, like new brakes, like the fact it was inspected. So digitalizing your used car folder builds relevancy. Additionally, you've got to display your top options. Unlike ABS brakes and AM/FM radios, start showing graphically in an ideal world the top things: nav, leather, backup camera, etc. This shouldn't be ranked on what you think it should be. It should be ranked on what means the most to the consumer. No different than the way Amazon behaves. Your comments should be impactful. They should focus on value, option, and reconditioning highlights. And that's, if you focus on these things, you'll drive your website traffic right into your showroom. And you're doing this through more relevant information, and that is absolutely how you win the click on websites. Now let's talk listing sites. How many of you do not list on AutoTrader or Cars.com? All right, I see one or two hands. So this will apply to almost everyone in the room. When you go to AutoTrader and you search, you select a make and a model and a year range. And if you scroll way down, you can put in options. Well, a lot of people have shown statistics to me that show that consumers do this. No different than we do on Amazon or any other website we shop. And the question I had is, can they find them quickly? So I searched for a 2010 Chevy Tahoe nationally, and there was 809 results that you can see on the screen. And to me, all-wheel drive is important, or four-wheel drive. So I went ahead and typed in 4x4, the way you see it up here. And as you can see below, 16 results found. Then I typed it 4x4 with no spaces, and there was 323. Then I typed four-wheel drive this way, and there was 673. You see, it appears that AutoTrader and others rely on the data that our inventory providers give to them, and as a result, it's not nearly as relevant as it should be because it's unorganized content. So to maximize your opportunities, you've got to think about the keywords that people are searching and make sure this is in your options and in your comments so websites like AutoTrader can even get you in the listings when that consumer knows exactly what they want. Now with that said, let's jump straight into the listings. And when you look at a search results page, this is where you can really win the click if you do things well. And the question is, what elements are in your control? Well, we all know photos. Some of us have photo overlays, others don't. Some of us have photo booths, some of us don't. And at the end of the day, we all know photos matter. And to prove that point, we did a focus group, and we asked one question. And the question was, which one is a better deal? This one or this one if they were the same price? And obviously, everyone said the second. Why? Because it looks more presentable. It looks the way you'd expect something to look when you go to Amazon. I don't look at an LG TV and it's dirty. So this is how consumers behave. You then look at comments. You control these. In fact, it takes up more real estate on the search results page for your vehicle listing than any other thing on it. And what should you put in your comments? Something that will win the click. You've got to have relevant content, and that relevant content has to be building value. You need to show value highlights and option highlights and reconditioning highlights. And during the break, any of our team members are gurus on relevancy, and they can give you some pointers and even pull up your website if you look, and we can look at comments. But you gotta focus on things. How many of you have custom comments? Quite a few. How many of you put reconditioning in those comments? Not many. We're spending money doing it. We need to show it. It sets our vehicle apart. It builds value. So these comments that are generic or irrelevant are always going to lose the click. The one that's going to win the click is the one with a smart comment, one that's promoting value, option, and reconditioning highlight. And then you look at other factors on the search results page, and you've got price. And sure, price is a factor, but we've learned so far that value is what matters most to consumers. Be competitively priced. I'm not suggesting otherwise. I'm suggesting that price isn't the only thing. It's not a race to the bottom. And lastly, your logo. You control your logo. Your Auto Trader rep may have built this logo for you when you signed up. This is something that some of the most progressive dealerships are changing on a monthly basis. And they're changing it with a message, graphically, that would help win the click, relevant to what their sales are or anything else. And if you do these things I just shared, you will absolutely win the click in listing sites. Now let's talk about search. Google pay-per-click is, without a doubt, the most exciting thing I've ever touched. It gives us the opportunity to market to more people than anything I've ever seen in a very targeted way. And in fact, I'm not here to say we're like Google in terms of size. We're clearly not. But the mission at PureCars is all around relevancy, and the mission at Google is very similar. We all use Google, or at least I do, and it's because what I search for, I see results that are relevant. When Google decided to monetize the searches with paid search, they didn't want to water this down. They didn't want it just to be bidding. They wanted to have some other factor, and they call that a Google quality score. It's real simple. If a searcher's request is a 2009 Honda Accord EX, a relevant ad is not a trip to Disneyland. It's about a 2009 Honda Accord EX you have. And when that customer clicks on it, they should go to a landing page showing you exactly that vehicle or details about that vehicle. And if you have a good click-through rate, you get rewarded with a higher quality score. It's out of 10 points. And you get rewarded by having a higher rank for a lower cost. You see, relevancy gets rewarded. Not to put words in Google's mouth, but relevancy matters. It matters to PureCars. It matters to everyone who shops every day. And they understand this, and I'm sure that's why the relevancy engine rewards you for relevancy. So it's amazing. We did thousands of searches, and we start looking. And as you can see on the screens, we did a search for a used Chevy Tahoe LTZ. And when you look at the ads, they all lacked relevancy. And when you look at what an ad should be, it should match the searcher's request. It should say 15 used Chevy Tahoe LTZs, some with new nav, new tires, brakes. You get the idea. Very relevant. You will absolutely win the click. This is an amazing search. I encourage all of you to do this at break. Search for a vehicle you have in stock with an option you know it has. And don't just look at whether or not your ad comes up if you're doing Google pay-per-click. Look to see if it includes the option that you just searched for. Every search we have done at our company, none appear. So I highly encourage you to really have a smart advertising approach where you're focused on dynamic content showing you your customers always highly relevant things, and you'll win the click from this and get rewarded. Now, when you think about relevancy, it's not just about long-tail searches for a specific vehicle, but it also goes all the way back to SUVs and everything else. So that's one piece of the equation on paid search. The other is your landing page. Should you land them back to your home page? Is that the most relevant page? Not if they're searching for a specific vehicle you have or type of vehicle. So maybe you land them on a search results page. Should you do this? What if a guy's searching for a Toyota SUV? It's really difficult. You know, at the end of the day, a search results page is not always relevant, so what you should be doing is landing them on a landing platform that never guesses at the right message. If somebody's searching for a new Honda SUV, show them a CR-V and a Pilot versus a typical search results page that looks like this. If they're searching for a CR-V, I'm sorry, the last one was SUV. If they're searching for a CR-V, show them the trim levels. Make it easy, make it relevant. And make sure you think mobile, because 47% of all automotive search queries are coming from mobile devices. Your ad shouldn't just show, your landing page better be optimized for it. And if you do these things really well, there's a good probability you're gonna master quality scoring and see really high scores, 8s and 9s and 10s. Now you should be applying the exact same thing here to search and site retargeting. So someone goes to your website, they leave, you have a $500 price drop on a vehicle that they looked at, that should be your ad. And if you do these things, you will absolutely win the click. So far I've covered how do you win the click with your website, how do you win it with listing sites, how do you win it with search and retargeting. And the next thing is, how do you maximize it? And you maximize it with synergy. How many of your dealerships have an ad calendar? Just a few hands. If I walked into any mid-sized business with a marketing department and said, do you have an ad calendar? I assure you, everyone would say yes. And the scary part is we spend more money in advertising than they may do, Now, I'm not here to talk about traditional. I want to focus this to digital. My recommendation is you create an ad calendar, and maybe February is trade month, and you're going to offer $500 more for your trade. And if you agree on this in your boardroom, the question is, what do you do with it? And my recommendation is you got to mirror your messaging on all platforms. Maximize what you're paying for. Synergy. Listing sites. Your search results page, if you can see, and I don't know if you can see it well on the big screens to the right, there's two bullet points. This one says, love Chevrolet, everybody does. South Carolina's number one volume Chevy dealer is the second bullet point. This is changeable, meaning you guys can modify it in almost real time. Is that the most relevant thing to show? Probably not. Well, if they have their $500 trade month going on and some other incentive, that's what you should show here. You should continue that on the VDP, in your comments, and in any other editable zone that the provider gives you, like AutoTrader or Cars.com may. You should make sure your website has this content. And this is really the piece that a lot of dealerships do well. They do put it in their website, but then it stops. Make sure it's in your pay-per-click advertising. It's all about synergy, because if you do these things, you can create a competitive advantage, and that's what matters most. You will absolutely master clicks. You'll maximize it. And you're not only going to maximize it, if you can implement what you heard from me today, and I know I was talking very fast, I only had 45 minutes, but I'm very confident if you do this well, you will absolutely create more showroom opportunities. I have several of my team members here that will be at our booth area out there, and we're here just to help you guys, and if you have any questions, that's what we're here to do. I appreciate it. It's been an absolute privilege talking to all of you today. Thank you.